Hello everybody, Thomas Sheridan here. You know me mostly from my vlogs and other discussions, rants even, and banter from the Thomas Sheridan and the Thomas Sheridan 2 channels here on YouTube. I also have a third channel. This is called Beyond Room 313, and this is a film channel. Mostly we do interviews and make films and documentaries here. And I would like as many of you to come over here and join me on this channel. We're growing membership of people who watch the channel. We have some great crew here and some great programs, and we've got more in development. Now, this video is a break from the usual 313 format in that I want to talk about a subject directly on camera. And this is to do with a subject called cosmism. Now, cosmism is a reigning force in the world today, and yet many people have never heard of it. It is essentially the embryo of transhumanism. Cosmism is a form of spirituality connected to astrophysics and space exploration. Cosmism's roots began with the earliest days of the Soviet space program. Because religion and the idea of a spiritual identity was rejected and punished by law even within the Soviet Union, they created this notion and fostered it among the youth that spirituality and the quest for a soul could be actually attained within space travel. So therefore, if you traveled into space on a rocket ship, you could actually attain a spiritual identity that wasn't available to you on this earth. Now, this became not only a propaganda tool for the Soviets, but a very real belief among many scientists. And there was a belief that they could do things like attain immortality. And this immortality could be attained by utilization of Einstein's theory of relativity as almost like a form of magic ritual. The concept of going deep into space, and as you return back, you're still the same age where everyone on Earth has aged. So a form of relativity was being used almost like a grimoire in order to evoke a demonic expression of the self in terms of an immortal space cosmonaut. They also believed that they could forego death and even raise people from the dead. You're traveling through space and you die while you're in deep space. What they can do then is go back into space to the point before you died, again using relativity as a magical script. And the point before you die maintain you at that point in the space-time continuum, so you would live forever, for all eternity. Now, this stuff is very seriously taken to this day by many elements of the transhumanist movement, who see cosmism as almost like their genesis from where it all began. And this belief that they have the singularity, which they hold sacred, the belief where the computers and artificial intelligence overtake the intelligence of normal human beings, is directly comes from the use of things such as the theory of relativity within cosmism back in the early Soviet Union. The thing is that what happened with cosmism, what caused its death ultimately, was the Apollo space program. We came back from the moon realizing that human beings could not really survive in space for long periods of time, that it had great effects upon their psychology, their physiology, and especially their spirituality. All you have to do is look at the initial NASA press conference of the first Apollo astronauts when they got back. And they look like three people who've been put through some kind of intense psychedelic experience, which is exactly what happened. This is why deep space travel is not possible. And just like H.P. Lovecraft told us, we were not meant to travel far. This is why, since the Apollo missions, all interplanetary probes have been unmanned robots, while humans in space, it's all been low orbital, ISS, Soyuz, space station, and a series of selfies being taken in orbit. That's really what manned space travel has become. And as a result, cosmism in its idealized form, as they had developed it from H.G. Wells and Jules Verne, had failed to bring this concept of human immortality, astrophysic necromancy, and other forms, spiritual and occultic crafts in outer space, was brought to an end. However, it didn't end there. It was transferred into something else. The concept of transhumanism and using everything from biomechanics to pharmaceutical augmentations to create a superhuman being. This is why the present day practitioners of cosmism in their current form have replaced the rocket ship with the needle, with the syringe, and seeing this as the methodology in which they can transcend what they believe are horrific limitations of human experience. So that's basically cosmism in a nutshell. It's a fascinating topic. It covers all kinds of things ranging from not only space travel and the concept of performing rituals in space, but also things such as art and music that has also been brought into it. And it's a tremendous subject that has not been studied enough by the alternative scene, and definitely worth a deep dive if you want to understand the academic and the scientific theocratic lunatics and dictators running the planet at the present time. To understand them is to understand cosmism. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like this and you want to see more, please subscribe, hit the like and share button, and there's also a Patreon page if you'd like us to help us produce films for this channel of higher production. We have a Bigfoot Sasquatch film in the works. We've already done Lever Providence and Lever Velocity, and there's lots more coming. So thank you very much, and please continue to enjoy the content here on Beyond Room 313. Thank you.